The new DigiGov online platform was conceptualized by the government of St. Lucia to revolutionize the delivery of over 150 government services. On Wednesday, September 30th, representatives of the island's 32 Minibus Drivers Association participated in a DigiGov stakeholders sensitization session organized by the Division of Public Sector Modernisation, which has been charged with the mandate to implement the project. The renewal and a duplicate of driver's license forms part of phase one of the three-phase project. Marlon Nassis is the acting director of Public Sector Modernization.
We're here today to present to you a new St. Lucia, one that is driven by technology and a concept that we're going to present by the government of St. Lucia, where we're going to revolutionize how government operates and the services that are provided to the public, to the general citizenry, to stakeholders like yourself, as you continue to engage government on a day-to-day basis, whether it's to access your services or just in regular processes that you undertake in your daily lives.
According to Mr. Nassis, the public transportation sector is a major stakeholder in the DigiGov project.
So we no longer want you to have to go through a long process going agency by agency to access one service. All of these processes would be integrated on one common framework, and you will be able to do it at your convenience. Stay at home and apply for your service. Stay at home and apply for the renewal of your driver's permit. You know, stay at home and apply for your theory test and these type of things.
Vice President of the National Council on Public Transportation, Michael Flood, who attended Wednesday's DigiGov stakeholder session, has lauded the initiative.
Oh, of course, they will benefit quite a bit because we have drivers based on the first-come, first-served system. Of course, they have to get to the bus stop to peg the buses. Without that, they would have to either take the buses off the peg or pay a bus fare to get to the ministry to do that. But this is something that could be done while sitting in the bus, at the bus stop, waiting for the queue. So I think it will go a very, very long way, and I think based on my understanding, bus drivers have welcomed it, and of course we will work towards making it a lot better.
The DigiGov project has also received commendations from the president of the Denry Minibus Drivers Association, Francis Edmonds, who also attended the DigiGov stakeholders session.
I have been somebody that has been very critical of the transport sector in particular, because as a minibus operator, there are certain things that I see happening at the transport department, and I'm not entirely pleased with it. But this initiative today, I think it really had me. I must say it's a fantastic initiative. I think it's going to be working wonders for us, especially with this world of technology. So I'm very, very happy with what I saw and what I witnessed today. Even as I sat at the meeting, I was already forwarding messages and pictures and so on to our WhatsApp group. And I'm definitely going to be meeting with my executive. We're definitely going to be taking that initiative to learn the process of how we go online to sign up and do all of the things that we learned today.
Participants were also shown a sample of the new driver's license and its accompanying features. The online platform will notify drivers when their driver's license is due for renewal. The DigiGov platform was launched on June 25, 2020, although registration onto the platform began on June 15th. As a result of this new online system, the waiting time for the renewal of a driver's license has been significantly reduced to 15 minutes. Services are available all day with real-time notification, short processing time, and can be accessed from anywhere. From the Communications Unit of the Division of Public Sector Modernization, Julita Peter reporting.